So Donald Trump has just quit the Screen Actors Guild, and he did it with a letter that is historic in being pathetic, petty, but also, if I'm being honest, extremely hilarious. And I want to read it to you together, and then I want to break it down a little bit. It says here, I write to you today regarding the so-called disciplinary committee hearing aimed at revoking my union membership. Who cares? While I'm not familiar with your work, I'm very proud of my work on movies such as Home Alone 2, Zoolander, and Wall Street Money Never Sleeps, and television shows including The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Saturday Night Live, and of course, one of the most successful shows in television history, The Apprentice, just to name a few. I've also greatly helped the cable television news business, said to be a dying platform with not much time left until I got involved in politics, and created thousands of jobs at networks such as MSDNC and fake news CNN, among many others. Which brings me to your blatant attempt at free media attention to distract from your dismal record as a union. Your organization has done little for its members and nothing for me besides collecting dues and promoting dangerous un-American policies and ideas, as evidenced by your massive unemployment rates and lawsuits from celebrated actors who even recorded a video asking, why isn't a union fighting for us? These, however, are policy failures. Your disciplinary failures are even more egregious. I no longer wish to be associated with your union. As such, this letter is to inform you of my immediate resignation from SAG-AFTRA. You have done nothing for me. Regards, President Donald John Trump. Guys, this is ridiculous, because let's be clear. If you in the first line of the letter basically say, who cares, and then write what you wrote, you're showing that you care. This is a man who's bothered by these sorts of things. He really is. He's bothered by these things as much as impeachment. He really is. Like, when he lost the golf tournament, when he lost Bill Belichick taking the Medal of Freedom, when he loses these symbolic things that tap into his celebrity and tap into the supposed respect he has from people that are prominent in Hollywood and in the sports world and in other aspects of the business world, it eats at him. And this is eating at him. Basically, this is a, you can't fire me, I quit sort of letter, which you only write if you care. The union was basically going to move to expel him because of his actions on January 6th in particular. Maybe not exclusively, but that in particular. And so he got wind of it, of course, and they're going to have a disciplinary meeting about him. And so he writes this big public letter, which of course he knows is going to be public because it's from the office of the former president, basically, saying, I don't care. It's just absolutely absurd, guys. This is a man that misses Twitter. This is a man that is really hurting for his Twitter account, because he has no outlet to just air his grievances and his random thoughts and have people read them and then have millions of people like and retweet these little things and comment at him, good, bad, and otherwise, and have, you know, be able to tweet something and then 20 minutes later have Fox and really every network talk about it. Just can't handle the lack of attention. So that's all this letter is. This is a sign that Donald Trump is at his weakest, his most pathetic, and his most desperate. Enjoy this letter.